Watch Infra TV, your digital economic channel on power, energy and infrastructure. Promoter Inertia Infra Media. Contact A. Prakash Iyer, Executive Editor on 0251-6500533. Mobile 0922-354-7582. 0932260-4411. Email infratv.eepl@gmail.com.
BHL has maintained its growth momentum into the third quarter of 2009. The orders booked up to the third quarter have been ₹36,425 crores, aggregating to about 14,990 megawatts. In fact, we have booked orders around 16,000 crores in the third quarter alone. In the power sector, up to third quarter, we booked total orders worth about 28,425 crores. Equivalent to 12,500 megawatts. Major orders in the third quarter include a ₹5,564 crore order from JP Associates for the 3x660 megawatt Bara project, ₹2,889 crore order for the 5x270 megawatt Elina Pill India Bulls project at Amaravati, ₹2,486 crore order for 2x600 megawatt project for Pipavav Energy. Another 2,889 crore order for the 5x270 megawatt Elina Pill India Bulls Nasik project. In the industry segment, we booked orders worth about 7,500 crores cumulatively up to this year third quarter, which includes about 1965 megawatts equivalent of captive power plant orders. In the international markets, we received orders worth about 967 crores till the end of third quarter, which includes about 546 megawatts power plant equipment orders. With these orders, BHL has currently an order outstanding of 1,34,000 crores as of 31st December 2009. 84% of these are accounted for by power sector and about 11% are by industry and exports. We are on track to reach a turnover of 32,000 crores in the year 2009-10. Now coming to the third quarter financial results, turnover up to third quarter for 2009-10 is ₹7,381 crores, a 15% increase over the third quarter of 2008-09. Cumulative turnover up to third quarter 2009-10 is ₹20,083 crores, an 18.6% increase year-on-year basis. Profit before tax for third quarter is placed at ₹1,644 crores. And cumulative profit before tax up to third quarter 2009-10 is ₹3,692 crores, which is an increase of 34% compared to the achievement up to third quarter 2008-09. Similarly, profit after tax for third quarter is placed at ₹1,073 crores. Cumulative profit after tax up to third quarter 2009-10 is ₹2,402 crores. Which is an improvement of 34% over the corresponding figure of last year. Raw material cost as a percentage of gross turnover net of excise duty for third quarter has been at 58.84% as against 61.86% in the corresponding period last year. In fact, up to third quarter 2009-10, it was 60.02% against 61.32% achieved in the similar period last year.
This is
driven by the lower material costs.
But sir, we are seeing a rise in commodity prices. So will that not impact on margin going ahead?
Well, the material costs which are now rising will affect our operations next year, because the currently whatever materials we are consuming is the materials which we procured earlier.
So what is this, sir? Some of the energy cost that is encountered by BHL, you must have some figures on the energy cost itself in machining, etc.
Energy costs are very not very significant in the in BHL. It will be of the order of 2.5 to 3%.
So congrats on the excellent result post for the company.
Thank you.
Sir, my question would be on China, threat from China competition. How is BHL poised to face this threat? Especially in the UMPP equipment category, there is an import from China and it has been increasing radically. So what is the policies which BHEL will...
See, we have followed the policy of basically giving better equipment to the customer. The performance of BHEL equipment has been, you know, the heat rates and the boiler efficiencies have been higher. In fact, we have introduced a 600 megawatt subcritical set, which has a heat rate equivalent to the 660 megawatt supercritical technology from China. In fact, if you look at this year order book, out of the 12,500 megawatts orders we received in the utility segment, almost 12,000 megawatts have been received from private segment, which are IPPs, and most of them have come back to BHEL after booking their first sets with Chinese. And in fact, India Bulls is an example of that, where they have placed on us 10 sets of 270 megawatts.
So, the question is actually, sir, the has recently decided that in UMPP, the developers will have to use indigenously manufactured equipment. So how do you see that impacting BHEL? Of course, it's a very positive move.
Yeah, that's an opportunity for the company. You know, this has been done with a view to see that the projects get serviced very quickly and their availability factors become very high. And yes, it's a very good opportunity for BHEL.
But the equipment that's used in UMPP is supercritical. How well equipped are you to...
We are fully equipped for supercritical sets. We are already... got orders for the 660 megawatt sets from NTPC and JP Associates, etc. And we are also now targeting 800 megawatt sets.
So don't you think there must be a technology anti-dumping instead of, you know, when the government says that the Chinese will be, you know, equipment can be countered by having Indian-made equipment come into the game. But we need a very large capacity. Don't you think a technology anti-dumping duty is a clear case in the case of Chinese? Why doesn't BHEL and other Indian manufacturers take this stand? Because there is anti-dumping duty for commodities. Why not there be a technology anti-dumping duty? Because it is be quoted at 30% below cost in a fair competitive environment. Why not use scientific method to counter this?
Well, I think some of these issues have been taken up with the government. But however, you compete with the... In fact, you should take that as an opportunity and improve your cost structure and make yourself, ability to compete. Your ability to compete should be better. That has been the stand BHEL has taken, and we have been able to compete with them. In fact, even in some of the international markets, we have been able to beat them on the prices. So we don't see that as a big worry for us.
So most of your orders again this time have tilted towards private players, IPPs. In fact, do you see this trend continuing? Do you see the PSU is actually making a comeback and taking more orders?
Well, it happens that this year most of the orders are finalized in the private segment, but then the public sectors also will come back.
So, can you talk about your raw material cost as a percentage of gross turnover, and where do you see it heading in the next quarter?
See, up to third quarter, we have done about 60% is the material cost on the gross turnover, and we expect that the material savings trend will continue till next year. And this is coupled with the, even though somebody said the material costs are going up, there are a number of initiatives in the company to reduce the costs. The design to optimization, lean manufacturing, such initiatives are in place. And therefore, we expect to control the material costs with all these initiatives.
So what about, looking at a target of becoming a 30,000 megawatt company by the end of the 12th plan? At the end of the day, we are talking of adding 1 lakh megawatt. If BHEL cannot suffice 30,000 to 40,000 megawatt, India cannot go 1,20,000, 1,30,000. That cannot be the target. India can never achieve that.
So, as you know, we are already planning 20,000 megawatt by end of March 2012. And beyond that, we will take a call in 2012. Before we reach 20,000 megawatt, a call will be taken. Should we increase the capacity depending on the market and the other competitors coming up in the country? So we take into account all the factors and decide. If there is room for increasing our capacity, we will definitely do that.
See, our neighbor is adding 1 lakh megawatt per annum, and this has been done over the last decade. So I think India cannot have weaker targets. And I think a strong company like BHEL should be looking at a very stronger target and convincing even the government, and even the private sector of India can come together, because it will be ultimately Indian companies who would finalize that capacity.
Well, we are open, looking at the markets. If there is a market, definitely we are going to add capacity. So right now the 12th plan size has been announced as 1 lakh megawatts. So for that we are going to have enough capacity. Our capacity itself will be 20,000 megawatt by 2012. So it's going to be available, and I expect another 10-15,000 megawatts to be available from the other players.
So you're asking for orders in Q4? Are you expecting that IPPs will of course be there? Are you expecting PSUs to come back to you?
Yeah, there are projects which are being discussed. So we expect that, you know, as I mentioned earlier, that, you know, the 50,000 mark, we have still the target. As I mentioned, 16,000 crores itself has been received in the third quarter. So order received is getting accelerated over, you know, as we go towards the end of the year.
Any plans on raising
funds? No, we don't. We have enough internal resources. We don't have any plans to raise resources from outside.
PSU dismissal talks going on.
Well, PSU disinvestment is the decision of the government of India, and I mean, in that I have not heard any plan from them to disinvest any portion of BHEL, their stake.
So whatever the capacity expansion the company is planning, it will be done through internal resources?
Yes, completely from internal resources.
So what's your fund outlay for the next fiscal?
Next fiscal we are going to spend, our capex requirement is roughly about 2,000 crores next year.
So what about components like forgings? Because this is an important component and there are barely 6 manufacturers worldwide. And of course, even BHEL is importing forging as a major part of this power machinery. So how do you see this? You know, is there any chance that BHEL may think of setting up its own captive capacity for forging?
No, as you know that we have our own captive capacity, but we manufacture in a limited way. But we are now enhancing its capacity, and we have recently signed a collaboration agreement with Sheffield Forge Masters UK. We are going to get this technology from next month onwards. It's going to, documents are going to flow, and this unit will start manufacturing in good numbers our own requirements. In addition, we are also looking at indigenous sources like Bharat Forge and HEC, and you know, there some of these things also we already experimented a few orders with them, and they are successful. Maybe, you know, some imports will continue.
Are you looking at any joint ventures in this coming to next quarter, especially in
nuclear
space?
Yeah, nuclear, as you know, that we have, we along with NPCIL, we are jointly looking at joint venture for manufacture of turbogenerator sets for the 700 megawatts. And I expect that this would get finalized by this quarter, the fourth quarter.
Quarter.
Yeah.
There was talk of adding a new partner in this existing joint venture, adding a new technology partner.
Which existing joint venture?
Between
BHEL
and NPCIL.
No, that's alone. There is no joint venture yet. We have signed an MOU. And this will be a tripartite joint venture, so whatever joint venture.
And third party?
We are in the process of selection of third party.
You're in talks with which companies if you can shed more light on?
All the international companies. It's too premature to talk about a company in this.
Okay, so when do we get to hear any decision on?
End of March.
See, sir, I want one very important question. You know, I've seen that the BHEL portfolio in the power mix of machinery does not have too much of renewable. Whereas there is a good case of BHEL working very in a forward way in areas like solar. Why a company like BHEL has not taken that initiative? And that's a potential area.
No, but I think you are not informed. BHEL has been a pioneer in solar PV. We have been present in solar PV segment for the last 30 years, and we have increased the capacity progressively from a level of 250 kilowatts 30 years back to a level of 8 megawatts currently, and we have executed number of projects in solar PV, all Lakshadweep, Andaman Nicobar Islands, Bangaram Islands, you know, the Sundarbans, we have supplied to Antarctica, some of our PV modules have gone there. So this is a focus area for us, and we are now, recently we received a 3 megawatt power plant order from Karnataka Power Corporation to set up a solar PV based plant, and we are looking at number of such opportunities. After the solar mission has been announced by the Prime Minister of India, we see a renewed activity in this by a number of companies, and we are trying to join most of these companies to leverage our equipment sale. Now, we have now finalized the wage agreement with the workers, and we will be paying the new salaries probably from 1st of March. So therefore, we don't see any provisions for that anymore. Now, all the provisions have been provided, and it takes care of that.
Okay.
What about the T&D equipment now? This all was in the generation side. The transmission and distribution sector, we are seeing the 800 kV, 1000 kV, and movement beyond that. You know, I'm going to say the technology side, including the transformers, including the switchgear, including all those switchyard and equipment, which will be a massive expansion requirement under the current circumstance if you're adding all that ultra mega thing onto the system. So how does BHEL try to,
See, we are a leader in the 400 kV segment, as you know, for the transformers particularly. And we are equipping ourselves for going to higher voltages like 765 kV and 1000 kV and 1200 kV. And we are discussing with for a joint venture in this area with the international companies. And maybe here again, you will hear an announcement maybe in the by the end of this financial year. Thank you.
Thank you.
If you are a power, energy and infrastructure company, advertise and promote your brand with India's topmost international grade publications. Energia, Asia's premier journal on sustainable energy and power. And Markonomy, the journal for infrastructure, water, environment and economy. Also presenting Markonomy Marathi, India's first and only regional language journal on energy, power and infrastructure sectors. Power your brands, advertise with our journals, partner our seminars and roundtables. Supported by Energia Foundation and REPA, Renewable Energy Promotion Association. Contact Falcon Media, email energia.falcon@gmail.com. Markonomy.falcon@gmail.com. Call 0902-9077245. 0902-9092223 0922354-7582.